Oh my gosh, it's game one.
I'll be sure to mention like the lack of moonwalks, because that's all I do.
Okay, okay. So here we are at game one on FD, Marth versus Ice Climbers. A tough matchup for Ice Climbers, as far as I'm concerned. I find that Ice Climbers have a tough time approaching Marth, because most of their best approach options are on the ground, and Marth has a great time zoning, especially on stages like FD, where they can't navigate platforms to improve their aerial game.
Yeah, it doesn't really seem to be bothering Alex, though, because he's doing... Oh, never mind. Drop edge guard.
So you're going to see Ogremaster 3000 here try to do a lot of fairish in the ledge. That's an easy way to speed up the Ice Climbers, and it's the safest way for Marth to get back on stage, so you can not get either down smash or something like that.
Wave dash down tilt's also a really good option.
I like it. I think it's an amazing option, and I'm glad that you mentioned that.
Ice Climbers can short hop fair over it, but god.
But why would they want to do that?
Because it beats it. That's literally all.
Now, I see that Alex is making a controversial decision here. Going with the Key Lime Pie Ice Climbers skin, that would be the green and sort of the cream color that you see Nana is. I don't know if that's going to help him here. Maybe he's hoping to confuse Ogremaster as far as who is Nana and who is Popo. I don't think that's true. I just made that up. So as you see here, Ogremaster gets a good sweet spot, comes on stage with the grab. Oh my god! Oh! Do you see that? You see that? Oh my! What's the up tilt? Who even needs it? Who needs it, really? Who does? Not me, not this guy. Ogremaster! Going out deep for that neutral air! Oh man!
Die.
Okay, so you can see here, you can see here that James is getting wobbled. Now, guys, I don't know if you know this, but there's not a lot you can do as far as getting out of a wobble when you're mashing. You have to mash out first before Nana is able to get going. You have to mash out really quickly at the start, or just not at all. You'll automatically break out as soon as you have frame advantage on the grab. However, what you can do is while you're getting wobbled, you can tap on your controller in a triplet rhythm. Just very loudly. I just use the palm of my hand on the A and the B button.
Just try and mess up their rhythm.
Yeah, you can, you know, as long as you're not moving your arms a lot or making a big scene out of what's going on, then I feel like it's fair that you can touch your controller as much as you want, you know?
Yeah.
I feel like you should be able to do that. I think it's pretty much the best. It's worked for me. Okay, Ogremaster finally picking up that first stock with the ledge grab. Let's go, Ogremaster. Falling in here at Ogremaster here at MLG Alex's apartment 2015. Oh, go space to that up tilt. Full hop neutral air. What was he thinking? Definitely gonna get dropped by a sponsor. As we all know, Ogremaster 3000 is sponsored by Straight Ripping. They're an MLG team. Famous their performance at MLG Orlando 2009, where they defeated Final Boss in Winter Semis of Halo 344. Okay. So Straight Ripping Ogremaster coming down, spacing some fairs, showing some crispy movement, getting hit by those ice blocks. Okay. Yeah. Okay, but it gets grabbed. Nice shield grab off that jab. I feel maybe he could have shield smashed you had that in and gotten a meteor punish with that wobble. Okay, he's setting up a handoff, hits him with the ice blocks. Ogremaster flailing to recover now. What's he doing? Counters to the blast zone. What is he expecting? Got in the game too. Here at MLG. Alex's apartment 2015. Straight ribbon Ogremaster floundering for a counterpick. Is he gonna pick Sheik? That's a terrible decision. He shouldn't do that. Marth Ice Climbers is a better matchup. I wouldn't say that out loud though.
Didn't see enough short hop fares.
Did not see enough short hop fares? I agree.
Or wave dash down tilt.
I agree. But
Or Nair for that matter.
Or Nair for that matter.
No.
Okay, so we're seeing Ogremaster 3000 sticking with the white Marth skin, even though he lost with white Marth last round. You'd think he would try to change it up. Get some green Marth in there, I feel like, is a nice spring color. Even though the weather's a little bit rainy outside right now, we just don't really know where it's going. You know, sometimes it's tough to tell when one season changes to the next season. You kind of have a moment, a seminal moment in the calendar where you get to go and look at the color of the leaves change. But for spring, you don't really have that. You kind of get more rain and the weather warms up a little bit. But who's to say what really is the first day of spring? Some people think it's the vernal equinox, which happens on March 21st, the longest day of the year, typically. However, we see Ogremaster here doing a wave land off the stage fair. I like that, but he's going to get stuck into a handoff. Definitely needs to start DIing that first grab from Popo down in the way so we can get a chance to tech. You get the tech in place, you can usually try to get out of Nana's regrab. Okay, nice space forward smash, dash dancing, full hops accidentally, I'm going to assume, but he gets out of that. What do we got here? Okay, okay. So, trying to do some pew pew you stuff off stage. I'm super cool. Okay, now he's getting grabbed by the popo. Let's see who's got better movement than neutral. Okay, looks like Alex does, which really should not be happening to a Marth. Nice light shield. Sorry when I burped. That was really unfortunate. Okay, so it looks like the Sopo is still going to pick up the edge guard. Let's see how much work Alex can do with the Sopo. Oglemaster flailing here. Flailing. Can he do it? Okay, nice jab. Sometimes you just gotta get the hit confirm off the jab, you know? Sometimes you just gotta feel it, you know? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So, as you can see here, Alex is doing some work with his Sopo. Gets the butt end of that nair. A little armpit. Marth's stanky armpits. Oh, dunks on top of him from downtown! It's the Oglemaster! I'm clipping the mic a lot, aren't I? I feel like I'm clipping the mic a lot. Let me turn down the gain just a touch. And then we're gonna turn up the volume just even a little. Oh yeah, that's great. You know, it's really great when you get a microphone with a large diaphragm like this. You can really tell the difference. Oh, Oglemaster just lost to Alex. Good showing from both players. Oglemaster definitely gonna be talking with his coach on Straight Ripping about what he's gonna do in the next round.
Next on stream, Sandy versus Supernova.